It was 1968. A church in Victorville caught fire, and as the pieces were being cleaned, the church bell was donated and unknowingly became a piece of High Desert history.
My name is Dan Hook, and I was the coach, head coach, football coach for 18 years, and then I was assistant principal for 19 years.
My name is Coach Police, Frank Police, aka Coach Police, and I'm an assistant principal here, but I coached football here from 1990 until 2014. 15 of those years I was a head coach.
My name's Matt Rohrbaugh. I used to be the head football coach here at App Valley High School for 6 years.
My name is Kyle Godfrey, and I am the head coach at App Valley High School.
The veil came the year before I got into teaching at App Valley High School.
It originated from a church, and the church donated it to Apple and Victor, and that's how it was, like 1960-something.
This is how the game started. Little did anyone know that the bell would become a symbol of the rivalry between two high school football teams, spanning from one end of the desert to the next. Apple versus Victor. The first bell game took place in 1969, but the rivalry went far beyond just two football teams battling for the bell.
The traditions have never changed, which is super awesome. Everyone gets super excited about this game in particular, and it's been that way ever since I can remember.
There's this ritual whenever we have to go to Victorville and play, and I'll never forget my first time going over there. We were driving on the bus, an old school bus, we always take school buses, and you're coming up on the top of the Narrows, and all of a sudden, Coach Hook turns to me. He was the head coach at the time. Coach Morgan turns to me. Hook. I get my ears confused. Hook was in 1990. He was the coach. I was on the bus. He let me go on the bus. And we're coming over the Narrows. And he looks at me and goes, "Wait till you hear this." And I said, "What?" He goes, "Just listen." So we go climbing up over the hill. And I already knew that the bell game was a pretty big deal, but I didn't really know about a bell game. You know, I'm 24 years old. Just came up from San Diego State playing football there. And when we got over the top and you could see the stadium lights, all of a sudden all you hear is snap, 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 snap. Because every player put their helmets were on when we got on the bus, but they snapped it when they went over. The tradition is, once you cross the Narrows into Victorville, you're ready to play football. And if you're not, don't even get off the bus.
Every day was really important. And we did things like, on Fridays, you couldn't wear green on the campus of Apple Valley High School. You could not wear a green shirt, or green pants, or green shoes, or a green hat.
The passion that the students and the alumni bring to the game is just second to none. You don't see that often at any high school events.
There's also another new tradition that's been going on for the last couple of years. The Apple High Fire Department, Blake Pratt, he's our chief. He played in a number of bell games for Apple High School back in 94 and 5-ish, 6. And he has the fire department, they come out and over Highway 18, just past the Selpa Center and all that, they take the ladder truck and they put an American flag. So on both sides of the highway, they go under an arch of American flags. And so then they go up to the top of the Narrows, and that's when they snap their helmets. So they've added to the tradition, which is really cool.
Oh, man, my favorite thing about Bell Week. Getting goosebumps. It's just the sense of community in the high school. Like, I don't think people understand how special Apple Valley High School is and how our spirit goes. And watching these students and alumni and administration get together for the bonfire, with burning this giant piece of wood, you know what I mean? And it's so cool that our school gets to have something so historic like that.
I definitely think the prayer that Coach Downing does before the game is probably my favorite pregame thing, just because it really just gets all the nerves out of me and just stuff like that.
Favorite tradition during Bell Week is probably the bonfire.
There are so many chants that go into the bell game because there's so many things, getting kids hyped up. And one of the things that I used to love coming onto the field too, because the kids just love it too, is just hard hitting, never quit. Hard hitting, never quit. Hard hit, never quit. And it's just the kids just get freaking amped and get going.
A song that I've done for bell games at pep rallies is actually one that a friend of mine would say as an ASB student to the crowd during pep rallies and games. my friend would do that. So I just continued it on when I became a coach to just kind of sing that song.
Way down in the valley.
Way down in the valley.
I heard a mighty roar.
I heard a mighty roar.
It was mighty Apple Valley.
It was mighty Apple Valley.
Coming in to kick the door.
Coming in to kick the door.
So keep your hand on the throttle.
Keep your hand on the throttle.
Keep your foot on the gas.
Keep your foot on the gas.
Look out, Victor Valley.
Look out, Victor Valley.
'Cause we're gonna kick your ass.
'Cause we're gonna kick your ass.
I remember playing in the band in high school.
Diss tracks were being recorded. And even more traditions that still stand today. A 53-year-long rivalry has seen faces from decades of generations. Former players and students now turned into parents, even teachers of the new wave.
I graduated in 2003 from Apple Valley High School.
I went to Apple Valley High School. I graduated in 2007. Played all 4 years of football.
My first Bell game, man, had been 1992 as a player.
I am a 1992 Apple Valley Sun Devils alumni, and also the mom of Jake, Josh, and Jared Soria.
Like, having my family through the generation of Bell game is pretty cool. Cause like my mom was a cheerleader and stuff, and then just even for the fans, but like people who are in the stands, most of them probably went to Apple Valley High School, or even for Victor or whatever, if their sons were to play for Apple Valley. But it's pretty cool to see that those same traditions are still going on as when they're in high school, and I think that's pretty cool that everybody can still have that same bond that they had back then.
Oh yeah, I definitely do think it's cool, like, to experience what my mom experienced, like, back then, and then also what my older brother experienced, and just passed down.
It's actually kind of crazy. My husband was a football player, and he played. I was a cheerleader, so I cheered in games, and now my son's playing.
I think it's cool because my whole family has played and watched it, so I guess it's my turn to play now.
We're all so connected here. So many alumni, so many ex, alumni cheerleaders, alumni football players, and now to come together and watch our kids either play football or cheer together is the best feeling. And when they say that Sun Devil pride is contagious, it seriously is, because now the bonds that we have formed as adults and as parents, they're unbreakable. And we tailgate before the games, we tailgate after the games, and we just are a true family.
Not to forget the former coaches who continue to support what the Sun Devils have grown into today.
I'm very proud of what's taking place at Apple Valley High School football.
There's nothing like being on the sidelines on a Friday night, lights, people. Sorry. I miss it a lot. I could do some things over in life, I would. So that my body would be able to still be doing this. But I love watching the guys that are out there doing it, because right now, this program has a lot of class again. They still hit like a son of a bitch, and that's what matters. When they play football, they bring the wood, they win, but they do it with class, and I love that that's back in the program.
I want them to play with pride, play with honor, and never give up.
To our coaching staff, you guys are seriously the most dedicated staff that I have ever seen. And as a parent, I appreciate everything that you do and sacrifice for these boys. So thank you. So go Devils.
There were pranks.
I was definitely a part of a lot of them.
Some of our athletes decided that they were going to go out and kill a bunch of rabbits in the desert. And they did.
They all went out and actually shot a bunch of jackrabbits with BB guns and hung them on the lawn at Victor Valley High School.
One of my favorite pranks? Probably around 1994-ish, when some kids, not sure who it was, really, painted the VV orange up on Hospital Hill. And you could see it game night. It was cool.
And then they sprayed numbers on the rabbits that were dead and threw them out in the field the night before the game.
We always paint that V on the hill orange.
Fun fact, my senior year, the volleyball team did it and might have gotten pulled over by the cops, but it's fine. Everyone's fine.
Tang in their pool, rabbits on the fence. It was always like mad pranks.
You know, back then we would go and run across the field and we'd grab the cheerleaders from the other side and we'd bring them to our side and we'd give them snacks and drinks and take pictures. And we actually had put X-Locks in their brownies and gave them brownies as a prank. X-Locks filled brownies as a prank. So that is one thing we did do.
They spray painted the entire inside of our campus. I mean, it was all green and all black and all rabbits. But Mr. Killian, who was our assistant principal, called in the district office and got everything painted from 6 a.m. till 8 o'clock. And it was all brand new again. So we took care of what we wanted to do. We didn't let Victorville, you know, beat us up or leave their mark on us. We didn't let them do that. Can't do that.
This is not something you try at home. I don't recommend this. That's a different era. Like people get in a lot of trouble now. Back then it wasn't as intense, so I don't recommend doing any of that.
Should we bring back pranks to campus? Absolutely.
Yes, we should.
Make pranks good again.
Ah, yeah.
10 years we've had the bell, and now it's going to be 11.
We're just going to prepare like it's every other game. I know it's big for the community and big for the student population. So I think that our kids are really excited about it, but we just take it the next game and one step at a time.
It's not if Apple's going to win, it's by how much.
There's no doubt that we're going to win. Victorville doesn't stand a chance. We have them. They can't do it.
Yes, oh, for sure. There's not even a question in my mind. It will be an 11-peat for sure. But looking forward to a good game. Hopefully Victor can maybe get a field goal.
We are for sure keeping the bell for 11 years. We're whooping them bunnies.
We are definitely going to keep the bell for 11 years.
Are we going to keep for the bell for 11-peat? Duh.
We are definitely going to keep the bell. I don't think there's a question in that.
Come on, that's no question. Of course we're going to keep the bell for 11-peat.
Yeah. I actually don't see in the unforeseeable future when the hell they're going to get a team put together to take it back, because our program is rocking and rolling and the Jackrabbits are kind of screwed at this moment.
So play your hearts out and remember that no matter what happens, just remember to leave the field and leave it all there.
And I want you to do what I tell you to do.
Say,
I'm only one.
I am not only one.
But I am someone.
But I'm someone.
I can't do everything.
I can't do everything.
But I can do something.
But I can do something.
Not what I can do.
Not what I can do.
I must do.
I must do.
And by the grace of God.
By the grace of God.
I will do.
I will do.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I am somebody.
I am somebody.
I am a sun devil.
I am a sun devil.
Let's get it. So this year, the 52nd Bell game, I better see you at the Bell game, because if you miss this, you're just missing out on history, because it's never been won 11 times, but it will be this time.